Choose life. Choose tram. Choose the train. Choose cars. Choose a taxi. Choose a moped. Choose a motorbike. Choose space offers. Choose a piggyback. Feeling lucky? Choose the bus. Choose eco-friendly. Choose fossil fuels. Choose low speed, high speed, wrist cameras. Choose congestion charges. Choose exercise. Go by foot. Choose life. Choose tram. Choose to check the timetable before you leave the house.
Shit.
Nottingham city centre, deep in the heart of the concrete jungle. Dull, dirty, and teeming with life in its most primitive form.
Hi, Barry Scott here. Friday night attracts all manner of creatures to this filthy habitat. But one, more than any other, conjures fear, awe, respect, and fear from the locals. It is the beast known locally as El Tramo. On a quiet summer's night, it's sometimes possible to hear the terrifying hunting call of this mighty beast. And when you hear this satanic cry, you have but one option. Escape as fast as possible.
Okay, that's a wrap. Let's go.
We're all done.
Hey, wait, I'm stuck.
What?
No!
What? No, there's a tram car!
Get him!
We were lucky, but the same cannot be said of our tram. He will not feed tonight. The life of a tram begins at conception. Here we see a male and female tram partaking in their ancient mating ritual. Maybe this wondrous act will result in a long-term relationship. If not, I'll be on that bitch faster than you can say silly bang and the dirt is gone. Which, while we're on the subject, can be purchased at most major supermarkets for a reasonable price.
One day our female will become pregnant. Maybe not today, maybe not tomorrow, but because of our extremely cheap budget, today. In fact, here's our little tyke right now.
Aww, aren't you cute, Tram Tim?
Over the long and hard 8-minute life of this tram, we aim to explore where it goes, what it does, and most importantly, who. To do this, we must place an electronic tag on the tram. Don't worry, this does not harm the tram. After all, it's a cardboard box. That would be sheer stupidity. So far, we are the only team to film trams in their natural habitat. Watching the tram's feeding habits was all good, and watching them screw was hot as a pepper army fire stick. But we still had failed to answer the biggest question of all.
Where do you think the trams go to at night?
Where do I think the trams go to? Trams or tramps?
Trams.
As in electric.
Got you.
I've no idea where they go to at night. I presume.
It's a bit of a mystery, really, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. Where do they head?
That's what we're finding out.
Okay, no, I've no idea.
Where do you think the trams go to at night?
Station, I suppose. They go to a station.
We hadn't thought of that one.
Apart from buses, the nearest thing to competition for a tram is a taxi. Here we see some taxis gathering together before going out on the hunt.
The main prey that both taxis and trams hunt for is the human. Weighing in at an average of 8.5 million pounds, these humans can run at speeds of up to 14,000 miles per hour. With such an intelligent prey, it's understandable that taxis and trams are highly competitive.
Filling up, Barry.
Jesus Christ! I can't believe my blue suede eyes. There's more sweat on me than in a fat man's neck creases. The taxi is waiting for the tram. Hey, prick, mop my brow.
Yeah, I'm pissing. The taxi had learnt his lesson. He must wait his turn. Luckily, there was no confrontation between the taxi and our tram, but that would have made television. Yeah, I really couldn't give two shits if it's a family show. Now you're gonna pay me my fuck.
Oh, they grow up so fast, don't they? Don't they? Come on, back me up here, guys. Not like that. Anyway, before I stray off topic, the tram, possibly the greatest creature to roam the urban jungle.
sleek, smooth, like a fine cigar on a summer's evening, with a fire and a nice bottle of wine and a dog to pat on the head.
Sadly, there comes a time for every tram when he must die, and unfortunately for our tram, it came along all too soon. I feel it's appropriate to the programme to show you our tram's last few moments in this world before he passed gracefully into the tram underworld. Thanks for watching. So I kicked her in the stomach and said, still want custody of the kids?
There's your latte, Mr. Scott.
Better be large, prick.